aquí también.
There's a kind of a unique situation, right?
Garvin and Sam McGuire's, who are contesting the AIB sponsored minor A football final. Now there's one change in the Ballygarvan team. Number 18, Ryan Quilligan, replaces Patrick O'Sullivan. And the team is in goal, Jack Murphy, who's captain, full back line, Alan Murphy, John Lynch, Dixon, Donald Brown. Halfback line, John Barron, Ian O'Leary, Martin Doody. Centre field, Gerard Fillan, David Murphy. Half hour line, Ryan Quilligan, who's playing the right. Kim Ashman, Liam Dillon. Full forward line, William O'Halloran, Thomas Cochran, Colin of Cahor, I think is the name on the forward. Now, Sam McGuire team playing as program in goal, Michael O'Regan, full back line, Sean Rice, Daniel O'Donovan, Gary Hayes, half back line, Paul Dean, Martin Murphy, Kenneth Burke, centre field, John Collins, Sean Hayes, half hour line, Julian Carroll, Fergal Lyons, Sean Farr. Full forward line, Michael Dwyer, Barry Norton, and David Moore. Now, the referee is Niall Ballard from Carrick Tools.
Welcome to Ovens, the home of Aero GA Club. It's the day of destiny for the minor footballers of Ballygarvan and Sam McGuire's of Dunmanway. We're here for the County Minor A football final. Ballygarvan having disposed of Kilmurry in the semi-final, and Sam McGuire's having disposed of Aaron's Own. Jack Murphy, the Ballygarvan goalkeeper, appears to have won the toss and has indicated that his team will play with the breeze that is playing from the clubhouse side here in Ovens. This game, of course, was to have been played last Sunday here in Ovens, but weather conditions dictated otherwise. Donnies would be the popular favourites to win this game, but this Ballygarvan side, as evidenced by the last display I saw from them in the Saudis final against Kinsale, are very determined and well coached by Pat Carolan and my old friend Paddy Ashman, and this side will not be easily beaten. A very even team, and they all certainly play for one another. The referee, inter-county referee Niall Barrett of Carrigtool, a referee of renown, I suppose, where red and yellow cards are concerned, just making the last few checks here, and the midfield pairings of John Collins and Sean Hayes from Sam McGuire's, and Josh Spillane and David Murphy from Ballygarvan, eagerly awaiting the throw-in. Last few checks and the game should be underway very shortly. Up goes the ball and up goes Spillane. But the ball breaks to a Donny player, the number 9, Sean Hayes. A long kick from Hayes up into the corner. Flicked on there but collected inside. And about to be cleared out by Donald Brown, the Ballygavin number 4, out to David Murphy. David fails to hold it. Gets it at the second attempt over on the clubhouse side. Boots this one across the field. And it comes to Liam Dillon and his marker. That's Paul Dean. Dean gets the better of it. The fair-haired Dean going up the field. Tackled there by Josh Spillane. Illegally so, says Niall Barrett. And indicates a free for the Dunmanway team. Playing into the breeze, but we have an injury here already. Up here, I think it's the centre-forward, Fergal Lyons, wearing the blue knee bandage for Dunmanway. Concern there for him. And the mentors going in to look after him. As Ger Spillane there, the number 8, one of the stars of this Ballygavin side, waiting patiently for the game to resume. Another star there, the number 9, David Murphy. Very strong midfielder. Referee's whistle sounds here in Ovens and play about to resume. Ball played up into the corner and a race across and is collected by the number 10, Damien Carroll, who lets the ball across and a kick in towards goal, but it's blocked inside by John Lynch, the towering fullback from Ballygavin. Lynch on the 13-metre line, kicking the ball out the far side. A race for possession over and ball collected there by Brian Quilligan. Brian to David Murphy. David takes his eye off it for the moment, loses possession but gets it back again, flicks it inside to the number 8, Josh Spillane. Spillane coming through on a solo run, being chased by Sean Hayes. Takes his shot and it's dropping inside and it goes wide on the left hand side. Goalkeeper there for Sam Maguire's Michael O'Regan, watching that one, placing this one now on the edge of the small square. Conditions here on the Aero pitch are fairly heavy, as you'll expect after the amount of rain we've had. It's a very overcast evening with rain threatening, but hopefully this won't happen while this game is going on. Ball goes off the hands of Thomas Coughlin, the Ballygavin full forward, but Daniel O'Donovan, the Sam Maguire full back, alleged to have picked the ball off the ground, and an opportunity after just 2 minutes for Ballygavin's free taker, Liam Dillon. Liam wearing the number 12 to take this one. A very consistent free taker here as he stands over it. Short run from Liam and a good kick. It's looking good and it's over the bar, over the red spot, and a good start here for Ballygavin. Just 2 minutes of play gone. They take the lead with a point from a free by Liam Dillon. Goalkeeper there, Michael O'Regan. Placing this one on the 13-metre line, straight in front of the goal. Taking a long run to it, he's kicking into this breeze. Not very significant at the moment, as you can see from the sideline flags. O'Regan kicks a good high one out into the middle of the field. Breaks off the hand of Josh Spillane. Josh Spillane going back after it. Sean Barron trying to get it. It's played inside to the tall centre-back, Shane O'Leary. Shane kicking it very close to the line, and it goes over the line. Almost kept in play there by Sean O'Hallan from Ballygavin. And kick is taken by Gary Hayes. But it only goes as far as Ger Spillane. Spillane coming back on the attack again. Lets a low ball inside. And Thomas Cochran has it. And Cochran lobs a high one across. Collected by Cullum. Yeah. Goal for Ballygavin. Great score there for Ballygavin. High ball in from the full forward, Oscar Hoare gathers it inside in the edge of the small square. Makes no mistake, blasts it across the face of the goalkeeper into the corner. A great stop here, a comic stop for Ballygavin. We're just looking at about 4 minutes play gone, and they lead by 4 points to no score for Sam Maguire's, exactly as they had done against Kilmurry. Built the scores early on, no doubt that's their game plan here. And Michael O'Regan, busier of the two goalkeepers so far to take this one. O'Regan kicks it out the scoreboard side and the far side. A race across for it there. Sean Hayes doesn't get it. They tumble over and a sideline ball. It's a free to Sam Maguire to be taken on the far side. Ball played up very close to the line. Corner forward coming across for it. David Maher doesn't get it and the ball goes out of play. And Alan Murphy brother of David the midfielder, leaving this one. And John Barron will be the kicker. Barron kicks a low one, runs on for the returns, collected by Josh Balan, passes it inside. John Lynch playing well out the field, out in the full-back position, following the full forward. Donnie's laid the ball in, good interception inside by Alan Murphy, the 15-year-old. Murphy taking a look, and a good kick down the field, blocked out there by Paul Dean. Collected by his midfielder, Hayes. Hayes lets the ball on inside to the number 11, the man who was injured earlier, Fergal Lyon. Lyon gets the ball in despite the attentions of Martin Doody. And it's kicked onto the full forward inside, danger here for Valley Arm. It's hit it across and over the bar. The number 15 for Donnie's a good Donnie name. David Moore gets the opening point. We're talking about 5 minutes gone and plenty of excitement here in Auburn so far, as John Murphy, or Jack as he's better known, the Ballygarvan captain, placing this one on the 20 metre line. A large crowd here in Auburn for this eagerly awaited tussle. Jack Murphy taking his time to this one. Good kick from Jack, almost from a standing position. Svelan is the man going up for it, dispossessed there by Barry Lawton. He's very close to the line. A tussle between John Barron and the number 12, Sean Farr, another great Donny name. Barron gets the linesman's decision. Shane O'Leary going across for it, but Shane coming across for on the soft surface. And Brian Quilligan trying to get it. Goes off the number 7, Kenneth Burke. And Barron kicks this one on again down into the corner. Centre forward Ken Ashman, son of Paddy, with it. And Ken has been tackled there by two players, illegally so. And a free to be taken quickly by Josh Balan, just stealing a few yards. But Niall Barrett, experienced referee, having none of that. And Jar now about 55 metres out from goal to kick this one across with the breeze. Gets it inside, well collected by Coughlin, the full forward. Lays it off to Ken Ashman. Ken takes a look, and a good effort from Ken. But there's a tail and it has just gone wide on the right-hand side. A great effort there from Ashman. Kicked it in, a pass from Coughlin, who's been very effective so far as full forward. Gets it in, but Ashman kicks it wide on the right-hand side. Michael O'Regan with the kick out from the edge of the small square, again favouring the scoreboard side, close to the line and over the line, and again this will put Ballygarvan back into the attack. Ballygarvan with practically all the pressure. Donnie's just 1 point to show so far. The ball breaks there off the hands of Coughlin, and Ken Ashman has it. Ashman lets in another high one, but again his compass is slightly out, favouring the right hand side, and again it's wide. 1-1 for Ballygarvan, and Sam McGuire's with a solitary point. 7.5 minutes gone in this first half. The tall Brian Quilligan, the number 18, a replacement there, a replacement for Padraig O'Sullivan, the number 10, unable to play because of illness. And Ken Ashman going across for this one. O'Sullivan is tugged out on the sideline. Ashman has it, kicks it back across the field, collected there by the number 3, the Daniel O'Donovan, the Donnie's fullback, up the far side, very close to the line again. But they're back into the attack. They're number 5 moving up that steam, very effective so far, getting a long ball inside to the number 10, but a weak shot from him and wide on his own side. But Niall Barrett decides that it's a free in for Sam McGuire's and for Damien Carroll. It's a free on the 20 metre line to the left of the goalposts. People still trooping in here at Ovens. An early start here. And even at that, I'd say we're going to be pushed for the light as the number 15 takes his kick and makes no mistake. It's the second point on the board for Sam McGuire. 2 points between the sides now. Bit of a chill in the air here as well this evening. I'd say that Chip fan in the background could do some business. And Jack Murphy not worried about that at the moment, concentrating on his kick out. Taking a run this time of maybe 7 or 8 yards. But again, he stops before he kicks the ball, gets it out, goes off the hand of Spillan. Shane O'Leary busting through, bringing down Sean Hayes. Not Sean Hayes, John Collins, the number 8. And the book is out. And the Number six, the red number six noted there in Niall Barrett's book. Conditions very slippery here. Bears losing their footing all over the place. Here's another chance for Barrett. Good block down there by John Van, very close to the line and out over the line. And the hand goes up for the 45. A 45 metre free for Darnies, playing into the breeze. Linesman going out there into the middle of the field to place this one for John Collins, who will be the taker, the tall number 8. Collins placing it and taking a very sharp one to the number 12. And kicking in the return, but it's collected by the full forward inside. A good back down there by Shane O'Leary. Back outside and kicked in by Fergal Lyons. Beaten away, good save by Jack Murphy out here to the corner forward. That's Michael Dwyer, a famous Irish name. Michael Dwyer kicks the ball over the bar, and Sam McGuire with the third point. Just a point between the sides now. Good block down there by Shane O'Leary and a good save. Inside, a dangerous ball lobbing over the head of Jack Murphy, but he got his hand to it. Point between the sides. 11.5 minutes gone in this first half. John Barron tying his lace. And referee Niall Barrett waiting considerately for him. As the ball comes out, Shane O'Leary breaks it down. Just Bland back helping out, gets it across here to Martin Dooley, the number 7. Dooley a very high ball into Liam Dillon. Liam doesn't get it. Dean gets the ball off the screen and good tackling there by Brown, the cornerback. Liam Dillon trying to get this one. 3 or 4 players around him. Dillon holding possession, plays the ball inside to Dooley. He flicks it on to Just Bland and Jarrett good kick down the field. And out comes the goal scorer, Colin O'Connor. No, it's the number 13 this time. William O'Hallam, William dispossessed, and the free to Gary Hayes gets the ball up the field, but only as far as John Barron. John Barron inside to David Murphy. David a kick down into the corner. William going across again. William O'Hallam doesn't get it. The ball is knocked away from him. Brian Quilligan is there to help him. Gets it back to David Murphy again, very close to the line. Toe to hand across the field. A race for possession. Ken Ashman laying it off to John Barron. Barron coming through on a good solo run. Tackled as he got rid of the ball, but it comes to Just Bland. Just seemed to be pulled there by John Collins. Yes, he was, and the referee's decision goes in his favour, just inside the 45 metre line. And this time it's going to be the number 9, David Murphy. David, one of two brothers playing in this team. The other, Alan, is playing at right cornerback. David taking a long run to this one, concentrating on his kick. Up he comes, and it's a good one from David. And a good effort by Colm O'Connor inside, but the ball breaks down and is collected by the fullback, who's alleged to have stepped out over the line. And it's a 45 metre free to Ballygarvan. Ballygarvan leading by a point at the moment. 13.5 minutes gone. And David Murphy will be the taker of this one here on the left hand side. Breeze now seems to have changed and seems to be blowing across the field. And David coming up to this one, a good bit of grass here on this pitch, but with the weather conditions, I suppose it's not possible to cut it anymore. And a mighty kick from Murphy, dropping in, and that's a great score, a 45 over the bar from David Murphy. 1-2 for Ballygarvan, and 3 points for Sam McGuire. Ballygarvan scores coming from the goal of Colm O'Connor and points from Liam Dillon and David Murphy. Michael O'Regan taking his time with the kick out here. Out into the middle of the field. Hands go up for it, collected inside, laid off to Sean Hayes. Sean Hayes lays the ball up the middle. Collected there by the corner forward, Michael Dwyer. Over to the far side. Good defending there. David Murphy coming away with the ball, hitting it to his midfield partner, Just Bland. And Murphy and Spillane off, and Just Bland off in a solo run. Going into the half-back line, lays the ball off to Brian Quilligan. Brian Buxton, 2, 3 or 4 tackles. Tries to get rid of it, is dispossessed. And the ball is cleared off the field by Gary Hayes. And added to up the field by the Sam McGuire centre-back. That's Martin Murphy, but Dally Garvin go back into the attack again. Liam Dillon has this one, escapes the attentions of Dean. Back to Spillane, and a good pass back to Liam Dillon. Liam going through, kicks it on the ground into the corner. Oklahoma, the goal scorer, has it inside, breaking away from his man. Seems to be fouled there by Sean Rice. And yes, Niall Barrett agrees with me. And it's a close-in free, and another chance here for Liam Dillon, a man on form at the moment. Pat Carlin there, the Ballygarvan coach, must be satisfied with his charges so far. Liam Dillon taking a good one up to this one, taking his time, getting his concentration right. And he slots it nicely across and again over the bar. A good point from Liam Dillon. Important to have a good free taker on this side, and he certainly is one. 1-3 to 3 points in favour of Ballygarvan. And we await the kick out. The scoreboard there on the far side tells the tale. Everything prepared well here in Air Oaks pitch. Part of a fine complex of four pitches. Ball broken down there on the far side by Tim Ashman. King going off in a solo run. He's tackled there. And the ball comes to the cornerback, Sean Rice. And Colm O'Crahore is on the ground at the moment, requiring some attention, a knock to his right knee. And it's going to be a free-in to Liam Dillon and Ballygarvan. A chance to restore a four-point lead. Niall Barrett showing him where the free is to be taken from. He's about 40 metres out from goal on the left-hand side, but the way this man is taking frees, well within his compass. Again, takes a good one up to it and takes a lovely kick over the bar. Plenty of height, plenty of distance. 1-4 for Ballygarvan. 3 points for Donnies, a four-point lead. 17 minutes gone in the first half here in Ovens. Plenty for the large crowd to enjoy here. And we await the kick out from Michael O'Regan. Plenty practice today for this man at kicking out. Good kick from O'Regan. Dropping out in midfield, goes over the head of Sean Bannon, but well covered there by Shane O'Leary. Down to Daniel O'Donovan, the fullback for Donnings. He's coming out, three Ballygarvan players around him. Knocked away from him by William O'Halloran, but it's collected outside by the centre-back, Martin Murphy. Murphy lays it back into the corner to Gary Hayes, and Hayes kicks it up the field, up to the other Hayes. That's Sean Hayes. Sean Hayes kicks it on past Tim Ashman up into the corner and the race for possession. Martin Doody going for a good move in his footing, trying to get the ball in play, but it's gone out for a sideline kick for Sam Maguire's over on the far side, just by the dugout, and the number 11, Fergal Lyons, gets the ball in field, collected inside by Maude, corner forward, but John Bam is back there, short kick out from Bam now to Josh Spillane, and Spillane kicks the ball up the field, and we're leaving James Duncan and Dylan's side, and Colm O'Crahore going for the ball with Rice, a judge to have fouled him, and the free is quickly taken, and David Hayes gets the ball further up the field. Collected there by Martin Doody, and back again to David Murphy. David putting his team back into the attack. Ball blocked down inside and again cleared out. And now Donnie forward, running out for this one. But John Lynch, the towering fullback, getting the better of his opposite number, Barry Lawton. He gets it to Josh Spillane, and Josh across the field, finding Ken Ashman. Ken takes a look and sends a searching ball inside. William O'Hallam coming out for it. Ball collected by Gary Hayes. And a foul collected by Gary as well. And a chance for Daniel O'Donovan, the Maguire's fullback, who seems to be suffering some kind of a mouth injury at the moment. A chance for him to take a free and clear his lines. Niall Barrett going back to checking him. We have just over 10 minutes left in this first half. A great performance from Ballygarvan here so far. Ballygarvan, I suppose, better known in the past as a hurling club, but the pendulum seems to be swinging here towards football at the moment. Much expected of their junior football team this past year. They disappointed, however, but they seem to have a very good bunch of lads coming through here. Free taken and goes out over the line, and a sideline kick for John Bowden on the far side. Showing the ball to the referee, gets the ball up into the corner. William O'Hallam's corner, well collected by O'Hallam, trying to get away from Gary Hayes. He's pulled there and he gets a free for his trouble on the 20-metre line over on the right-hand side. And Niall Ballas bringing the ball back there for Liam Dillon. Liam has scored his free so far from the left-hand side, and this is a chance for him to try it from the right. And the way he's playing, who'd bet against him? Again, taking a good long one up to this one, thinks about a short one, but changes his mind. 9 minutes left in the first half, and a kick from Dillon and a cross, and over the bar. Another point from Liam Dillon. Well taken there on the far side on the 20-metre line. And that's 1-5 for Ballygarvan to 3 points from Sam Maguire. Kick out again to be taken on the 20-metre line. O'Regan running up to it. Gets a good kick out into the middle of the field, but Ballygarvan winning most of these exchanges so far. This time John Collins has it for Maguire. Gets the ball up the field. Collected there by Lynch again. A towering fullback back to another big tall man. Shane O'Leary, but Shane a bit astray with this one. Out over the wire on the far side. And the sideline ball for Kenneth Box, the number 7. Just waiting for the football to come. The scoreboard there in the background shows the score at the moment. 1-5 for the red and whites of Ballygarvan and 3 points for Sam Maguire. Another ball going in there to Kenneth Box. Just 7 minutes left in the first half. The full forward doesn't get it. Lawton loses possession. It's come to Jos Milan. Jarre gets a ball low down. Collected by Daniel O'Donovan. Gets the ball out to Kenneth Bach again. And Bach kicks the ball up the field into the hands of Alan Murphy. Alan coming out under pressure there from David Maher. A judge to have been fouled. And Jos Milan eager to take this one. Lets it back there to John Barron. And Barron takes a short one inside to Brian Quilligan. The tall, lanky Quilligan, the judge to have fouled that one. And it's a free up the field. On the far side, John Collins, the number 8. Collins sends a low ball across the field. Good tackle there by Shane O'Leary. Liam Dillon coming out, doesn't get it. But Jos Milan has the ball and gets it inside to Coughlin. Coughlin, who's been quiet for a while. That one breaking off and cleared up the field. Collected here by Michael Dwyer. Dwyer sending the ball across to the far side. Lawton, the full forward, going for it with Alan Murphy. Ballygarvan full back line playing very well at the moment. Murphy, Lynch and Brown gets the ball down the far side to Daniel O'Donovan. O'Donovan a short one inside. And Donny's trying to build on the attack again. A high ball up into the corner. And it comes off the hands of Brown. But collected there by Martin Doody. And Martin Doody gets the ball out to speed. Out to David Murphy. These players finding one another very well. Liam Dillon has it now. 2 minutes around him. Dillon fouls. Wanted to take a quick one, but Niall Barrett wants to take out the Law Nota, and he writes another name down, and John Barron to take this one in his own half of the field. Instructions there from Shane O'Leary. Barron gets the ball over to the far side. Coughlin running for it there with Bork. Bork getting the better of this one, but Tomás Coughlin isn't beaten yet. Bork sends a low one up, and a free for Sam Maguire. Taken on the far side by Kenneth Bach. Collected there by the full forward, Lawton. Gets the ball across to his number 12. That's Sean Farr. John Lynch going back for this one. Lynch under pressure, but collects the ball well. Right to tackle. And the judge has been fouled as well. No, actually, the free is given the other way. He must have been penalised for over-carrying, which I think was probably a bit harsh. But it's a chance for Sean Farr to reduce Maguire's arrear somewhat. Farr taking a look, already scored 1 point and adds to it that time. Casually kicks it over the bar for his side. 4 point. That's 1-5 for Ballygarvan and 4 points for Sam Maguire. Just 5 minutes left. Large crowd here, many familiar faces from Ballygarvan. Red and white flags in abundance. And Jack Murphy, Jack having an easy afternoon so far, concentrating again in this one with this unusual kicking style of his. gets the ball out the field collected there by Fergal Lyons. Lyons kicks the ball up into the corner and a race across for possession. And Dwyer is going across for it. Gets the ball across to his number 12. That's Sean Farr. Farr hand pass across to Collins, the midfielder. Collins leaves it there. And it comes to Lyons. The number 11 and Lyons kicks it in. And the hand goes up, indicating that it's a 45, that it came off the hand of a defender. Conbone there with two sheets tied together. A red one and a white one, showing his loyalty for Ballygavin. And the 45 to be taken by John Collins, the number 8. Looking for a spot to place it, looking for a suitable divot. Thankfully the rain's still holding off here in Ovens. And Collins taking a long run up to this one, indicating to the referee that he wants to replace the ball. Not happy with it. Shifted there by the wind and again taking a long run up. Kicks it in, it's a good kick from Collins. A dangerous one inside, it breaks. Out here and collected by Martin Doody. Hand pass from Matthew Doody outside to Joyce Spillane. Joyce Spillane seems to have been fouled, but Donnie's got the advantage. But the ball is kicked wide there by the number 13, Michael Dwyer. Joyce Spillane there coming over the ball, two defenders around. Seems to have been fouled, but the free not given and a let off for Ballygavin and Jack Murphy. Jack taking this one from the edge of the small square.
Come on, Leo.
Out he comes and gets the ball out of stock around the 45, collected there by Joyce Spillane. There are four tackles and Gerald gets the free. And John Barton looking for this one, looking for somebody to pass it to. Lets him inside to Liam Dillon, the number 12 has it, rounding his man. Trying to get away from Paul Dean, sends it low along. And collected there by Thomas Coughlin, and Coughlin fouled by O'Donovan, the fullback. And Joyce Spillane, he takes this one out of the hand, gets the ball inside. Ken Ashman losing possession, Thomas Coughlin has it again. And a Donny player fell over that one, that was Paul Dean. Seemed to be touching the ball on the ground, but I suppose the referee is allowing for the conditions. Gets the ball out to the number 12, Sean Farr. And the ball is cleared up the field eventually. Martin Doody's the man that collects it. The number 7 very close to the line. Seemed to go over the line. They kept the ball in place. Shane O'Leary has it. Shane losing his footing again. And back to Martin Doody. And Doody, a good clearance down the field. But two forwards trying to block him down. Collected there and kicked up the field by Martin Murphy. Back to John Lynch. And Lynch is a good clearance to the other. No, it's collected there by Fergal Lyons. And Lyons seemed to lose the rhythm of this play. And John Barron sits there as Lyons gets a free in about 35 metres out from the Ballygavin goal. Seemed to have lost possession, but referee give him the free. And the number 12, Sean Farr, with about a minute and a half to go to half time, maybe a small bit extra for injuries, Farr to take this one, kicks it out of the hand and kicks it in by, hits the post inside, collects it inside and clears back out the field. A race for possession. The race is won by the number 5, Paul Dean, out to Fergal Lyons, and Lyons kicks the ball in and kicks it over the bar. The 5th point for Sam Maguire, kicked over the bar by Fergal Lyons, the man with the blue bandage on the lead, the team captain. And it's 1-5 to 5 points here, and we're coming very close to half time. And Jack Murphy with the kick out. Jack standing over this one. Again, the shortest one to Shane O'Leary. Shane kicking the ball over the far side, very close to the line again. And over the line, and Kenneth Burke. 1-5 to 5 points there on the scoreboard. Kenneth Burke kicks the ball back into play. And it's collected there in the middle of the field by the midfielder, Sean Hayes. He gets it across to the number 5, Dean. And Dean gets it to the centre-back, Martin Murphy. Murphy kicks it very close to the line. And a race across for Damien Cowell, the number 10. Doesn't keep it in play. And pull back there for Ballygavin. John Lynch decides to leave it over to John Barton, the number 5. and he kicks the shortest one to Shane. Shane seemed about to take a tumble again, but held his footing at that time and gets it into Josh Bellan. Josh Bellan back to John Dominic again. Nice and prepared. Dominic took his eye off it, collected there and cleared back up the field, up to the number 10. And Donnie's back into the attack with Sean Farr. And Sean going through, hand pass inside to his number 10. And another nice pass to Lawson, the full forward. And he gets it back to the number 10, who seemed to pick it off the ground. A high Gary Owen up in the air. And it comes back. Oh, just touched over the bar there. Touched over the bar by David Marr. But earlier the ball appeared to have been kicked off the ground by Sam McGuire up there. But the point is awarded, and it's now 1-5 for Ballygarvan, with 6 points to Sam McGuire. We're into injury time here in the first half in Oven, and we have 2 points between the sides, 8 points to six, and as Mihala Mahertig would say, it's all to play for. The ball breaks off just the line, collected by John Hayes. And Hayes is judged to have taken too much out of it. And the other John, John Barron, to take this one. Darren stealing a few yards, but getting away with it. Gets it over to the far side. And Buck, Kenneth Buck, the Sam Maguire's left halfback, kicks the ball out over the line. And again, John Barron, free taker in chief for the Ballygarvan defence, to take this one. On the sideline, Shane O'Leary, telling him to cool it and take his time. He sends a shot and inside to David Murphy and back to Barron again. Looking around and kicking the ball down into William O'Halloran's corner. It breaks to Daniel O'Donovan, but there's time for no more here at Ovens. It's 6 points to the team in green and white in arrears by 2 points. That's Sam Maguire, and 1-5 to Ballygarvan. Ballygarvan leading here by 2 points, all to play for in the second half. Back with you shortly. Niall Barrett checking his watch. Second half about to commence. No changes in personnel that we can think of here or that we can see. And the midfield pairing is the same as in the first half. Collins and Hayes for Sam Maguire's and Gerald Spillane and Dave Murphy for Ballygarvan. And the ball is thrown in and the game is on the second half and broken down by Josh Bellan. Ken Ashman coming out with it, collected by John Collins. Donnie's determined in the second half, get the ball down, but the ball is collected inside in the corner and cleared out the field. And it's a free to Donald Brown. Ballygarvan over on the far side, and Donald kicking this one up the field very close to the line. Liam Dillon has it, lays the ball inside. Dave Murphy up the field, a good ball up into the corner. O'Crahor, the goal scorer, the only goal so far. Number 15 over on the far side, two defenders around him. Back to Liam Dillon. Responsible for a big slice of the Ballygarvan tally of 1-5 in the first half. Gets the ball inside to Coughlin. A good layoff from Coughlin to Spillane. And a low ball along the ground. But for some reason, the referee seems to think that he touched it on the ground. And Daniel O'Donovan, the red-headed O'Donovan, the number 3, gets the ball out the field, out into the middle. And a race for possession over on the far side. Collected there by the famous Irish name, Michael Dwyer. And again, Dwyer has it. Evades a tackle there, but gets a low ball across the field to Lyons, Sturgill Lyons. And trying to get past just the line, but no way. Gets the ball back there to the number 9, John Hayes, and Hayes finds no way to either get to get the line. Good tackling here and good defending by Ballygavin. Not giving an inch. The ball breaks inside to Lawton to pull forward. Does a roll over on the ground and gets back to the number 10. And the ball is picked in by Damien Callan. Collected inside by Jack Murphy. And a good save comes from Jack over to the far side. Maybe not as safe as I thought. Collected and sent back in by Dean. Breaks off the hands of John Lynch inside. And Jack first comes it away out to Dean. And it's over the line for a sideline ball here on the near side, about 13 metres out for the Donnies. And the number 12, Sean Farr, coming across to take this one. Kicks a short ball inside, but John Bowman is alive to it. The ball is knocked out there to the number 10, that's Damien Carroll. Carroll very close to the end line. A tug on the jersey, gets the ball back to Farr, and Farr kicks the ball across the field, and it goes across the face of the post and wide. This breeze has strengthened a lot, as you can see from the flags hanging on the netting, and it's blown into the far corner as Miles Bally goes in there and replenishes the supply of water for the second half, and Jack Murphy to kick out with a breeze neither far or against him on the edge of the small square. Pitch holding up well here in Ovens, and Jack kicks this one. It's a better one this time than the ones in the first half. Out into the middle of the field, collected outside by Hayes, and Hayes pulled and hauled, but the play continues. And Lyons kicks the ball across to Farthing, number 12. Gets the ball inside again, just one here, and it's kicked across the face of the goal. Wide again, this time on the left-hand side. Two chances there for Sam Maguire's, with just 3.5 minutes gone in the second half. And Jack Murphy with another kick out. Jack a bit busier than he was in the first half, but that's to be expected. Maguire's 2 points in arrears after the first half, bound to come back at Ballygavin. Jack picking out his options. Gets the ball out the field over on the far side again, added to by Shane O'Leary. Up the far side. Dean seemed to be pushed in the back there, but then he seemed to pick the ball off the ground. And it's collected by John Collins and Niall Ballard. Giving the free to Sam Maguire. Collins kicks the ball inside. Collected inside by Moore and lets it off to Collins again. And again a high. Gary Owen the kick taken away by the breeze. And Jack Murphy, the Ballygavin captain, gratefully going across to pick this one up and place it again on the corner of the small square. Just heading up to 5 minutes gone in the second half. And Jack with another run up to this one. Kicks it up the field. Very close to the line. Collected there by Donald Brown. And Donald sends a low ball inside to Liam Dillon. Liam adds foot off the field. And collected there by Ken Ashman. And Ken, looking for somebody to pass it, but decides to leave it free and leaves it to the number 8, Josh Bland. Just over 5 minutes gone in the second half. Josh Bland with the kick up the field. Thomas Cochran trying to collect it, doesn't collect it. The central back marking actually going back for Sam Maguire. They touch the ball on the ground and a chance for David Murphy. Kicking into the breeze this time. Inside the about 40 metres out from the Sam Maguire's goal. David just getting his bearings there as Niall Ballard goes in and has a quick word with one of the umpires inside. Coming across, somebody's in trouble here. And he's speaking to the number 4, Gary Hayes, the marker of William O'Halloran. And Hayes' name going into the book despite his protestations. Good work there by the umpire, and the first card in the match, a yellow card for Gary Hayes. And David Murphy to take this one. Kicking into the breeze, well within his range, a good kick from Murphy going in and through and over the bar. The first score of the second half for Ballygavin and David Murphy. 1-6 for Ballygavin, and the 6 points for Sam Maguire. 6.5 minutes gone in the second half, and Michael O'Regan with the kick out on the 20 metre line, right in the middle of the field. Ballygavin Managing each time Sam Maguire's come close, managing to stretch that lead back to 3 points again, which is a safe lead. And Kim Ashley has blocking that one. Now comes to David Murphy. David Murphy leaving the bar inside. Collected there by Brian Quilligan. Quilligan lobs it inside. It's blocked down by Dean and collected by the goalkeeper Michael O'Regan. And eventually cleared off the field over to the far side. Collins, the number 8 midfielder, fisted on to number 12 Sean Farr. And Sean Farr kicking the ball down the field, but very close to the line. Martin Dooley there watching the ball going over the line. And it's a sideline ball on the far side. But Martin must have touched it. It's taken there by Michael Dwyer down into the corner. Full forward, Lawton seemed to handle it on the ground. And Lawton has it again. Being challenged there on the far side by Alan Murphy. And the ball gone out over the line. And a sideline kick on the 13 metre line. Martin Dooley to take it, being told where to take it by the linesman. And he kicks the ball up the field over the scoreboard side, collected by the wing back, the number 5. Dean gets the ball inside. John Bowden doesn't get it, collected inside by the number 10 and laid back to his further lines. Further wearing number 11 under pressure there. Good pressure there from John Bowden, not letting him loose. Good matching there by Bowden, and helped there by the number 4 Donald Brown. But over exuberance on the defender's part results in a free about 30 metres out on the left hand side. A free there for Sean Farr. Bar going toe to hand at the moment, looking at the post and kicking this one in, and it's a high one and it's going across the face of the post and wide on the far side. And the scoreboard shows that there's a 3 point advantage to Ballygarvan with 8.5 minutes gone in the second half. Things looking good for Ballygarvan and Pat Carlin and Pat Ashman here at the moment. And the kick out to be taken, Shane O'Leary running for it, and just the land goes highest, comes off his hands, collected over on the far side by Martin Murphy, the centre back. Murphy, a high Gary Owen type kick in, broken out by the other Murphy, Alan Murphy for Ballygarvan. Outhouse battle number 15, and kicked in and kicked wide again on the right hand side by David Moore.
Come on, Valley.
Jack Murphy facing this one. 2 footballs inside now at the moment. That breeze still blowing directly across the field, not favouring anybody at the moment. And rain still holding off here. Kick out again. Fisted down by Lyons. But Alan Murphy coming away with the ball. And he's beaten this time by Michael Dwyer. Dwyer over on the far side, 3 Ballygarvan defenders alone, and gets away from Martin Dooley. Lays the ball back inside to Dean, into Collins, and Collins taking a look. Is this a better one? No, it's wide again. Wide on the far side. Strong breeze blowing across there. I remember in the first half where Ken Ashman had a couple of efforts like that taken away by the breeze, taken away to the right. So maybe it's not as easy to score down there as one might think up here. And Jack Murphy with the kick out again. Just 10 minutes gone in the second half. Jack with a lower one this time. Collected by Donald Brown. Donald Brown lays the ball back for only as far as Lyons for Sam Maguire. Lyons kicks it in, and again, fifth wide in the row for Sam Maguire. Wide on that same side. As Carlin looking on here, I'm sure Pat is very satisfied with his charges at the moment. Things going in their favour, working well for one another. And Jack Murphy, Jack, an inspirational goalkeeper with the kick out. Steady kick out into the middle of the field. Shane O'Leary has it. Shane trying to bust it. It's John Bowden. Both are tight here. First, John Bowden lifts the ball up to Brian Quilligan. And the referee's whistle blows. Shane O'Leary not happy with John there. And it's a free to. It's actually a throw in to Sam, or to Niall Barrett, the referee. And he throws the ball in. Just the land breaks it down. Being brought away there now by David Murphy, and David kicking the ball up the field, setting his team back into the attack away between Kinnock and Brian Quilligan. Breaks back to him, the centre back. Murphy has it. Good shoulder there from Josh Bellan. Murphy getting the ball back, to broken in by Quilligan, and eventually cleared out by the cornerback Sean Rice over to the far side. Collected there by Michael Dwyer, roving out the field. Now Dwyer sends the low ball inside, collected and cleared back out the field. and Doha racing for this one again. Challenge there with Brian Quilligan. Ball collected there by Buckley, number 7, and a judge to have lifted it off the ground as number 13, Michael Dwyer, lies on the ground. Injured with 12 minutes gone in the second half. Maguire, Sam Maguire's mentors going in. And we wait for play to resume here. John Dong ready to take the free, and the linesman showing him the spot where it should be taken from. An exciting tussle here in the second half again in Ovens. These two sides pretty evenly matched. Ballygarvan having the slight edge at the moment. I'm sure there'd be a lot of celebration and rejoicing on the banks of the Onabwe if the cup goes back there tonight. And I suppose a special toot of the horn as they pass through Ballinhassig, the home of their great rivals. And number 13 here, Michael Dwyer. Michael getting a shot from the magic bottle. A cold evening to have water fall down your neck, but it seems to have worked. And John Dobbin with the kick. A low one from John. Inside to Jeff Spillane, and Joe gets the ball off the field into the corner. William O'Halloran seems to be tumbled over there. Yes, Niall Ballard going in. And it's a free in for Ballygarvan. At an acute angle, about 15 metres out. And David Murphy going fast to take this one. The clock shows exactly 13 minutes gone in the second half. David seems to have taken over the free-taking duties at the moment from Liam Dillon. But he'll run up to this one and send it across, but not Sweeney is far enough. And wide on his own side, 20 by 20 distance, but his direction was off. And it's a kick-out for Michael O'Regan of San Miguel on the edge of the small square. Good kick by O'Regan, dropping out into the middle of the field. Great fielding, magnificent fielding there by Josh Balan. Lost his footing as he landed, ball cleared out by Kenneth Brock over to the far side. Collected there by number 7, well collected by Martin Doody. Fouled in the process, and it's a free for Martin Doody. He moves the ball across here to the near side to the number 18, that's Brian Quilligan. Brian busting away from Kenneth Brock, and fouled by Kenneth Brock as Connie again waves the sheets in front of my camera. And John Down with the kick up into the corner. William O'Halloran again on the ground with the ball collected by the man who had his name taken earlier, Gary Hayes, and Gary out to Sean Farr. Farr over to the far side, collected by Michael Dwyer inside to Lyons, the centre forward, and Lyons kicking the ball inside. Ballygarvan, the fingers waiting for it. The ball is collected by the number 10, that's Damien Cowan. Damien lays the ball inside and over the bar. A point there for Sam McGuire. Well rocked, their first point of the second half. Teams with a point each, 1-6 to 7 points in favour of Ballygarvan, with 14, almost 15 minutes gone in the second half here in Oven. Another kick out for Jack Murphy, this time from the 20 metre line. Jack taking his time with the placing and positioning of this ball. His team leading by 2 points at the moment. Short one from Jack. Gets this ball up and it's collected over on the far side. Sam McGuire back into the attack again. Collected inside by Lawton. He seems to throw it up and catch it again. Yes, Niall Babbitt agrees with me, and it's a free out for Ballygarvan. And John Lynch leaving it to John Barron. He's looking for somebody to pass it to. Here's the ball across the far side, collected. He has somebody all right. It's the number 12, Liam Dillon. Beats his marker, Paul Dean gets the ball up. Collected there by the centre forward, Ken Ashman. Finishing the low ball inside, but it's collected by Kenneth Brock. Here's the ball out to Collins, the midfielder, out to the centre back now to Murphy. Murphy coming up into the attack now, into the Ballygarvan half back line. Shane O'Leary goes to block and down, he sinks the ball inside, but Jack Murphy, the custodian, watches it, goes harmlessly wide on his right hand side. A lot of wides here from Sam McGuire's in the second half. We're over the halfway stage of the second half. We're just over 15 and a half minutes to play in this game. Ballygarvan leading at the moment by 2 points. kick out from Jack Murphy. Landing out in the middle of the field. Collected there by Michael Dwyer. But it's free to Ballygarden, taken by John Barron out to Shane O'Leary. Shane doesn't collect it and breaks away from him. He's very close to the line. Picks it off. Under pressure. Kick block down. Out over the line. Kick block there by Sean Farr. But it's a sideline ball to Ballygarden. Pat Carlin issuing instructions there from the sideline. And there's a change in the Ballygarden team as Brian Quilligan comes off. And the man he replaced goes in instead of him. That's Patrick O'Sullivan wearing number 10. Shane O'Leary with the ball very close to the line. Fraggle Lines has it for Sam McGuire's. And the linesman alleges that he crossed over the line. I think it was a bit harsh myself, and he's not too happy about it. But it's a sideline ball for Ballygarden and John Barron. John wearing the number 5, taking most of the frees in defence. It's a load up the field. Collected there by Patrick O'Sullivan. Collects a foul as well. And another chance for Ballygarden. This one will probably again be taken by David Murphy. David coming up to take it. About 45, 46 metres out from goal. David kicks a short one low along the ground, collected inside by Tin Ashman, laid back to him again. Good play here. But the ball is blocked down by Malcolm Murphy, and he kicks a low one. Collected there by Michael Dewar. Michael on the ground. In house by Malcolm Dooley. Leaves the ball there. And the free will be taken by John Collins, the number 8 for Sam McGuire's. Collins looking for somebody to kick it again, kicks a short ball inside to his midfield partner Sean Hayes. Hayes kicks it on inside. John Lynch collects it well. Toe to hand. Bring up his options. Kicks it back across his own goal. But it's collected by Shane O'Leary. Nobody was doing there. Shane lets it out the field again. And Alan Murphy coming away with this one. Good play, Ballygarden, from the whole possession. Alan Murphy has it again. Tackle, does he kick the ball? Play goes on. And the ball is collected by Malcolm Murphy. The McGuire centre back very close to the line and pushed over the line. And the sideline ball again to Ballygarden. And the man to take it will be the midfield of Josh Plan. So, trying to pick somebody out there, a lot of pushing and dragging at the moment between Daniel O'Donovan and Thomas Corkin. Inside the ball is knocked inside. William O'Halloran gets a ball to it. And it's kicked and kicked over the bar there off the bulldog. William O'Halloran, a good point there for Ballygarden. Lifts the pressure on them a bit. 1-7 for Ballygarden. That's a 3-point gap again. Sam McGuire's had 7 points. And their goalkeeper Michael O'Regan to take the kick out again. With just 10.5 minutes left in this second half. And well connected down in the middle of the field by David Murphy and Ballygarden coming in the attack again. There's it inside to Ken Ashman. Ashman a good chance of this. Kicks it over the bar. 2 points in kick succession from Ballygarden. As Sam McGuire's beaten, well, the next 10 minutes will tell. But Ballygarden applying all the pressure in the last few minutes. And another kick out here for Michael O'Regan. Taken quickly, collected out in the middle of the field. And laid off there and cleared down by Daniel O'Donovan down the field, very close to the line here. Alan Murphy racing across the field, very well killed. Alan Murphy lays the ball inside his brother David. David is pushed to the ground. Josh Brown comes into the action. Oh, a heavy high tackle there by Kenneth Burke. But the referee allows the play to go on. Alan Murphy dragged to the ground. Surely there's a free at this stage. Small little altercation broken up by Josh Brown. Wisely so, and Ballygarden getting the free very close to the sideline. Josh Brown, ball in hand. Waiting for the referee's whistle. Kicks it across the field over to the far side. Ken Ashman is the man going for it. Colm O'Crohore has the ball inside, lays it back out to Ashman. Nice pass. He's two-man facing in the centre-back. Martin Murphy pulling off and he sends a low ball inside. It's blocked inside by Gary Hayes. Coming out very close to the in-line. Gets the ball out. A good chance for Hayes. Out to his centre-back, Martin Murphy. Out to the far wing. And John Collins bringing the ball away for Sam McGuire. Kicks it down into the far corner. It's collected inside in the corner by David Moore. Good drop down there by Donald Brown. And Marr finishes up on the ground. And Sam McGuire finishing up with a free. We have just 8 minutes left in the game. And the scoreboard tells the tale. 1-8 for Ballygarvan. 7 points for Sam McGuire. Have we a historic victory in the making here for Ballygarvan? Their first county title ever. Time will tell as John Collins is about to take the kick on the 45-metre line for Sam McGuire. Sticks it in. Good high ball up inside. Breaks into Jack Lofton. Coolness personified. Lays it out this side and out over the sideline. Ollie Hallahan watching on there. Ollie must be a proud man today. Done so much work for Ballygarvan. Ball laid inside to Fergal Lyons, to number 11, but he loses his footing as he tries to go past David Murphy. Ken Ashman, the other centre forward, has it now. Summer Teddy heading up the field. Kenneth Buck cutting across the line for him off, but Ashman playing well now, showing his true potential. A star for Colossity 3 as well. Lets the ball there, Kenneth Buck taking it. Kicks it down the field, down into the far side. Michael Dwyer going across for that one. Oh, dispossessed, but he blocks it down again, but the ball is eventually cleared out by Martin Doody. Collected there by Liam Dillon. Liam goes to the ground, and Sam McGuire go back into the attack, but a good interception by Alan Murphy. Dispossessed as he tries to clear the ball, but he still has it. Great play by Murphy up the field. Pavigo Sullivan tosses for it, he's on the ground, and he gets his swing. Little bit of getting to know you there between himself and John Collins. But he's conceded his free because of that. John Bowden arguing the toss, but rules are rules. And the referee, Niall Barrett, has the ball and will throw it in between Josh Villan and Sean Hayes. Josh Villan gets it and gets the touch to his midfield partner, David Murphy. Dispossessed. Slipping and a bit of pulling and dragging here now. Josh Villan very close to the line. Villan using his strength has the ball. Alan Murphy coming in to help him. Josh Villan picks it up again. Lets it up the field. Liam Dillon tussling for it, and Liam Dillon seems to be foot trips. Yes, his foot trips out in the middle of the field, and another name going into the book, another one of the Sam McGuire's defenders, and the ball is left there to John Barron. We have just over 5 minutes left in the second half. John Barron, the low ball across the field. Liam Dillon tosses over it under pressure from Paul Dean, but he still has it. Josh Belland collects it in the middle of the field. Gets a kick up into the corner. A race for possession there. Colm O'Crohor, the number 15. O'Crohor has it inside to Ashman, being shadowed by Martin Murphy. Then Ashman collects it, takes it up into the corner. Playing for time now. Sensible play by Ashman. Defenders cutting off him. He's dispossessed eventually by the midfielder, John Collins, but Ken Ashman points back well. Dispossessed again. And David Murphy coming in to help. David Murphy, chance to lay it off. He holds on to it. He takes a look and he kicks it in. A good kick with a small bit of a tail in it and wide on the left hand side. But at this stage of the game, with time to be away, I suppose, it could be as good as a score. Michael O'Regan falls Sam McGuire with the kick out. Small delay now at the moment. Ball is kicked out eventually. It's collected out in the middle of the field. A tussle there between Sean Hayes and Josh Villan. Josh conceding the free. And Hayes kicks it down towards the scoreboard. Collected over by that sub who came in. That's Gerard Kelly, the number 17, gets it across the Fergal Lyons. Lyons kicks the ball low inside. He's shown for the 16, number 15, David Marr. Lays it inside. It's good news here now, but Josh Villan is back helping out his defence. And Gerard Kelly has it on the ground. Lays it after David Marr. And Marr kicks and kicks over the bar. Kicks over the bar. That makes an 8-point tally now for Sam McGuire. 8 points for Sam McGuire and a goal in eight for Ballygarvan. 3 points in it. Still a safe lead with 4.5 minutes left of normal time. 1-8 to 8 points here. History in the making at Ovens. We await the kick out. Some great performances here from individual Ballygarvan players today. The two Murphy brothers, Gerald Spillane, Ken Ashman at centre forward, some excellent performances. Liam Dillon with his free kicking as play continues here. McGuire's back in the attack and over. Great save there by Jack Murphy. Great save. Tapping back of them. Flicked it out for a 45. Hugging on his defenders. Good save by Murphy, who hasn't had that much to do in fairness. But when he was needed there, a mighty save. and it's a 45 to Sam Maguire's great urgency here now, as they know that time is running out for them. We're running down to about 3.5 minutes, and John Collins, the number 8, will be the taker of this 45. Picks out the spot. He'll probably play a short one with time ticking away. Yes, he does. He kicks it low along the ground. Collected there by Lawton, the full forward, but he loses possession. And who's back helping out but Liam Dillon? The half forward line coming back now to help out the defence. Gets the ball across, but it's collected there by Daniel O'Donovan, the full back coming out with his own bit of attacking. Waves the ball inside, and who goes up for it but Spiller, and a collapse in the middle of the field. John Lynch loses it. John Lynch, another star today, and Donald Brown, very solid at left cornerback. Brown wins the free this time. Or does he? Niall Barrett not making his intention clear. I think he's going to throw the ball in. Yes, he's going to throw it in. Josh Spillan steps in for it with the number 9, his shadow all day, Sean Hayes. Spillan gets it again. Gets it out of start of Michael Dwyer, and Dwyer gets it. Another good save inside by Murphy, under pressure, and kicks it back out the field. Great defending there. The other Murphy, David, going for it, but losing possession. And Paul Dean, one of the Maguire's better players today, sets it to Sean Farr. He lays it across the further line, and he kicks it in, and he kicks it over the bar, narrowing the gap back down to 2 points. 1-8 for Ballygavin, and 9 points. 9 points for Sam Maguire. 2.5 minutes left in the game. Jack Murphy taking his time now, placing the ball here on the 20-meter line. It's been an entertaining, tough struggle here also. Great football considering the conditions. Nathan Doody collecting that one. If he had already comes off a forward, but Liam Dillon collects it anyway. Liam, the number 12, coming back, out the out of defence. He's pulled down, lays the ball out to Josh Bullard. Out to David Murphy, nice sidestep by Murphy. Kicks the ball across the field here. Collected by Shane O'Leary, the centre-back, going up into attack. A low ball from Shane, the pass very close to the line. A tussle there, and the ball goes out off the boot of Paddy O'Sullivan. And he's marker. Kenneth Bach kicks the ball down the field, collected there by Sergio Lyons. Much was expected of Lyons today, but in fairness, Shane O'Leary has done a great job of him. Lyons gets the ball inside to David Maher. David Maher pulled down by Donald Brown, and the free to be taken on the left hand side. Well, in fairness, Donald having his name noted in the referee's book. In fairness today, Sam Maguire had missed a number of frees from almost that identical position. And Sean Farr, the number 12, he kicked this one again. And he bring another point for Sam Maguire. He kicks it in. Yes, it's over the bar. It's 10 points for Sam Maguire. 10 points. And the goal and the for Ballygavin. That's 11 points to 10. Just a point between the teams at the moment. A slender lead. We could be looking at another day out here as Jack Murphy prepares to take the kick-off. There are only 20 seconds of normal time remaining. Jackie made 2 vital saves in the last 10 minutes. Kicks this one down the field. A tussle forward. Ball breaks to Alan Murphy. Alan operating now on the left hand side, gets it up to Liam Dillon. A beautiful kick by Dillon. Inside to Colm O'Hall, inside to Ken Ashman Dunkley. He can see the issue here. He beats the full back, he's busting through. Can it stop? Hopped off his Ashman, has pulled down. He's got help there. He still has possession. He's pulled down again, gets it back to Colm O'Hall trying to bust through. There's it back inside, it's collected by Kenneth Bach, and Bach kicks the ball down the field. Who's Bach to it? It's collected inside by David Murphy, the right man in the right field. A great kick from Murphy across the field. It's collected by Cavill O'Sullivan. And not quite there, O'Sullivan, but he still has the ball. He's still got time. He lays it back. He swims. He's intercepted by Sean Farr, the number 12, brought to the ground. And Farr to take the kick himself. Kicks it down the field. Collected by David Murphy. Maybe Farr would have been better off to leave it to somebody else. And David Murphy gets it back up the field. The cross is up possession inside now. Collected by the full forward, Thomas Coffin. Right on here in the second half. Paddy O'Sullivan. A great kick. As it's coming off. Yes, it's a great point. A vital point for Ballygavin. Takes them back into a 2-point lead. 1-9 for Ballygavin. 10 points for Sam McGuire from the big stadium, most of them belly garden, for Ryan with excitement. Ball in the middle of the field at the moment with John Collins from the midfield. We're into injury time, half a minute into injury time in the second half. Breaks off the hands inside of Daniel Brown to his opponent. David Moore with belly garden had it, and the ball is cleared back out to the field. And the regular gone, it's all over. History made by belly garden. 1-9-2, 10 points. Glorious victory for them here in Oven. A historic day for the club. Congratulations to Ballygarden. A fine victory fashioned by a fine team here, but commiserations to Donnie. In a way, they must be congratulated too for their contribution to what was a fine game at this time of year in these conditions. An excellent showpiece for minor football here in Cork. The final score here at Aero Grounds in Oven. Ballygarden golden line, that's 12 points. And Sam McGuire from Dunmanway, 10 points.
Indeed, they were one of the losers. They were very close in the end, and maybe I as a neutral wouldn't have cribbed if I had to come in up of there. But maybe, you know, that's not what was due to happen, and we had to have a winner in the day. I have a number of people to thank. I thank AIB, our sponsors. They're represented here by Aidan Hurley, who's a Carrigaline branch. He's the Neil French Valley Garvin. He's the Lord Man, and he's at the home for the moment. And I'd like to thank AIB for their continued sponsorship of the minor board. I'd also like to thank Aero Club for putting their facilities to us today. The excellence of the field and their arrangements with car parking. I'd like to thank them sincerely for that. To the referee and his officials, I'd like to thank them indeed as well. A difficult task, and they'll never really appreciate it. But they do a thankless job, and I'd like to thank those people. So, I'd like to thank the Belly Galvin and say, I suppose the staff to the EU get long odds that they'd win this championship. And, you know, to their credit that they came and won it, they created a few surprises along the way. And indeed, looking at them here today, you can see why. They wasn't spoken about, I can tell you early on, as being winners of this championship, but they're here. And without further ado, I'd like to present this trophy. The first time.
Achievement in itself to come here and back into the framing, mate. So I own 2 Charles Rodinis. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! I'd like to thank the supporters for cheering out today and a round of applause for them. Thanks to Ovens for the drums and our 2 trainers, first of all Paddy Ashman, and a big roar for him, lads. Most of all, Paddy! My mother couldn't wash him. This is a notice, y'all.
I'm going to go to the hospital.